So that's the description of mean shift as applied to segmentation. I will tell you, it's a very strong technique. The cool thing is it automatically finds these basins of attraction. So you don't have to tell it how many modes there are. You just tell it, in fact, there's one parameter choice, essentially, which is that window size, how big that Gaussian is. There's also, when you talk about that, because you're operating in a feature space, you actually have a distance function, right? Because when my Gaussian is over some distance, so if I want to scale color more than texture, oh, texture, we haven't talked about that yet. All right, we'll do that next. Or color more than luminance, you make that decision ahead of time. So there's this parameter choice of window size, but there's also a general distance metric function choice. But you have that in every sort of clustering that you do. It doesn't make any assumptions about the shape of the segment in the image, or the cluster in the image. It just does this in the probability distribution of the pixels. And it's a very generic technique for finding multiple modes. And people use mean shift for a variety of things, like tracking, when we actually talked about doing that previously. As in anything else, there are some downsides. It does depend on this window size, and sometimes figuring out that window size is a bit of an art with respect to the nature of the set of the images that you're looking at. And the other problem is, because you are sort of moving in feature space, and you want to make sure that you get a reasonable number of points within your region of interest in order to shift for the mean. Well, suppose you've got a big feature space, right? And what I mean by that is you've got 50 dimensions. Well, almost by definition, your feature space will be sparse, right? Because the sort of the number of little, if you let's suppose you carved up every dimension into like 10 buckets. Well, if there's 50 dimensions, right, that's 10 to the 50th buckets. So by definition, there's going to be lots and lots of buckets that have hardly any points in them. So mean shift needs you to have a reasonable number of points within that region, so it doesn't work as well in high dimensions.